You are welcome to Geojay GIS Solution Tutorial Channel. I am Peter MJ Adaviruku. Today, I want to show you how to solve interpolation problem. Interpolation like IDW, Kriging problem. How to solve it. In a situation where you do your interpolations, instead of covering your study area, it just covers part of it, just like what you are seeing on the screen by the left side, which I label error. So you want to solve it to be like this so that it will cover your whole study area. That is what I want to show you, how to solve this error. Please remember to subscribe to this channel. Thank you. So let's open our ArcGIS now and bring in one data to illustrate this. So click on add. Let's navigate to where our data is. So I want to use this field data and this study area. Click on add. In few seconds it will be added. So it has been added. So in this data, let me make this study area hollow. Click on it. Click on hollow. Let me increase the width to 3, for example. Yes, I have it here. This field data is a point data. If I open the attribute table, right click and click on open attribute table, I want to see the attributes that are in this data that I want to use to illustrate the exercise. So I have the longitude, latitude, I have the strike and dip. So let's say you want to interpolate this point with dip, for example, this field. So let's illustrate it. Click on arc toolbox, come to spatial analysis tool, click on it, then come to interpolation. This interpolation, click on it. So let's just use any of these interpolation technique to illustrate what we want to do. In this exercise, let's just use IDW, double click IDW, and it will open a table like this. So here under input point feature, click on it. We are using our feed data. Then this Z value field, we want to use our deep field, this deep. Then let's just navigate to a folder where we want to save it. Here, let's just call this IDW1, for example, and click on save. Then click on OK. So the process is running. Background, we want to see what the result will be. So the result is going to give us error. It will not cover the whole of our study area. And we want to see how we can solve that error. Yes, you can see. You can see now that it doesn't cover our study area. This is the boundary of our study area, but the result we are getting only cover part of it. How do we solve this problem? To solve it, let's uncheck this. To solve it, let's go back to IDW, double click. Here again, we are loading in the same data. Click on it. This is feed data. Then the feed we want to use is still our dip. Let's navigate to the folder where we want to save it. Here, let's just save it as IDW2. So click on save. Now, this is where to solve the problem. To solve the problem, come to environment. Here, environment. Click on environment. Then here, under processing extent, click processing extent. The extent of this analysis, you click here, same as layer study area. So what it means is that you want the process to run and cover the whole of your study area. Then you scroll down, and you see raster analysis. Click on it, then scroll down again. You see mask. So you want to mask the result with our study area. Click on study area. Then click on here, click on OK. So we have set the extent of the process and the analysis. So click on OK. So the process is running now. We are going to see the result it will give us. So it will solve the problem and cover our whole study area. It says, you can see it now. So this is how to solve it. So it has covered our study area. So to solve it essentially is to set the environment, telling the software that the process should cover your boundary, your study area. This is how to solve the problem of interpolation error in ArcGIS or any other GIS software. Please remember to subscribe to this channel. Thank you for watching. Please share.